Eggcreme is an ingredient that I only saw recently in my skincare products. For example, when I reviewed the Geek & Gorgeous Hydration Station that contains eggcreme as featured ingredient for skin protection. That made me curious. After all, I'm always excited to learn more about skin beneficial ingredients, so I sat down to look through the data available of the use of eggcreme in dermatology and subsequently skincare. What did I find? Let's talk. If you're new here, welcome! I'm Dr. Anne, a physician passionate about skincare and well aging. Eggcreme is a so-called extremolyte, a name given to a group of substances produced by bacteria that live in extreme conditions like high salt concentrations, extreme heat, or intense UV radiation. By structure, it is an amino acid, and it sometimes also goes by eggcreinum or L-eggcreme. The way it works is by accumulating in high percentages outside either the bacterium or the structure it is protecting, forming a film around said structure to prevent dehydration without interfering with the cellular processes. Basically, a layer that still allows the bacterium to do everything that it wants to do, but prevents it from dying. Apart from being used in skincare, we will come to that in a minute, and from being used by bacteria, eggcreme has a long history of being used in ophthalmology to help with dry eyes, the effect of seasonal allergies, and with healing after a surgical intervention or a trauma to the eyeball. There's also some preclinical, meaning from the lab, not from humans, data on it being used on lung cells to prevent irritation after exposure to pollution particles, where it works by stabilizing the lipid layers, and on gastrointestinal cells to lessen irritable bowel syndrome, again by reducing the effect of the inflammatory cascade. Out of these, though, only the use in ophthalmology has data on the effects in actual humans. First and foremost, eggcreme is a moisturizing ingredient that prevents transepidermal water loss. On top of that, it is currently recommended for the use in atopic eczema, especially in children, where it positively influences skin dryness, pruritus, and dermatitis, and when used together with other medication, reduces the need for corticosteroids. It has also shown to be as effective as dexpanthenol in reducing retinoid dermatitis in people undergoing isotretinoin therapy. It also has a protective effect against inflammation triggered by environmental stress and pollution, as well as a protective effect against UV radiation, at least when looked at in the lab. But just to be crystal clear, it does not replace sunscreen in sun-smart behavior. The recommended maximum concentration of eggcreme in cosmetics is 2%, so you will usually find between 1 and 2% in your products. Compared to that, 5.5 to 7% are what is used in formulations for the treatment of atopic eczema, but they are over-the-counter medication, so not skincare. At the same time, you can't just take the effects you get from a 7% formulation when treating atopic eczema and assume that 2% will have the same soothing effect. It might, but we don't have as much data. So basically, up to 2% is what you will get in skincare, and if you want to treat a medical condition, go for the over-the-counter version. Eggcreme is considered safe for everyone, including people pregnant and breastfeeding, with the obvious exception that you can be allergic to anything. There are no reports of adverse events even with prolonged usage in higher concentrations, and no reports that it might negatively affect other ingredients you pair it with. While the anti-inflammatory effect could be presumably helpful in people suffering from acne, it is not specifically studied for this purpose. So the only thing that we know is that it is helpful to mitigate the side effects of isotretinoin therapy, which in itself is a very good thing, as many people stop the treatment because of them. Eggcreme is recommended as supportive treatment for people suffering from atopic eczema and has, especially in children, shown to reduce the dryness, pruritus, or itching, and in general the need for corticosteroids in the treatment. It is used at concentrations higher than the ones available in skincare, though. I've personally tried two products with eggcreme, both using it as a concentration of 1%. The Geek & Gorgeous Hydration Station Gel Cream that combines the 1% eggcreme with 6% glycerin and is a lovely hydrating and lightweight moisturizer that I can recommend for oily skins and for the summer months. And the Balea Expert Day Cream that combines it with 3% peptides, but that I personally don't enjoy as much texture-wise. I also discovered that my eye drops contain eggcreme, but that isn't the topic of today's video. I will leave a few more product suggestions in the description box. Ectoine is an amino acid produced by bacteria to protect them in harsh living conditions. It has been used in ophthalmology for its anti-inflammatory and protective characteristics and has also shown to help against inflammation and irritation in atopic eczema and retinoid-induced dermatitis. While medication uses 5-7%, skincare can contain up to 2% max, so you can't say for sure if that will give you the same protective effect, but as it is well tolerated, there's probably no harm in trying it. If there's anything you would like to add, please do so in the comments below. I will link to more videos you might find interesting on the screen and at links to my Instagram, blog and Patreon account in the description box. See you soon. Bye!